Today we are going learn about the lesson Rulers and Buildings Part 2. Why were temples destroyed? Since the kings built temples to demonstrate their devotion to God and their power and wealth, it is not surprising that when they attacked one another's kingdoms, they often targeted these buildings. In the early 9th century, the Pandyan king Sri Rama Sri Vallabha invaded Sri Lanka and defeated the king Sena I. The Buddhist monk and chronicler Dhammakitti noted, he removed all the valuable, the statue of the Buddha made entirely of gold in the Jewel's Palace. The next Sinhalese ruler Sena II ordered his general to invade Madurai, the capital of the Pandyas. The Buddhist chronicler noted that the expedition made a special effort to find and restore the golden statue of Buddha. The Chola king Rajendra I built a Shiva temple in his capital. He filled it with prized statues seized from defeated rulers. The list included a sun pedestal from the Chalukyas, a Ganesha statue and several statues of Durga, a Nandi statue from the eastern Chalukyas, an image of Bhairava and Bhairavi from the Kalingas of Odisha, and a Kali statue from the Palace of Bengal. Sultan Muhammad of Ghazni attacked the temples of defeated kings and looted their wealth and idols. But by destroying temples, especially the one at Somnath, he tried to win credit as a great hero of Islam. Imperial style of the Vijayanagara period. The city of Vijayanagara was developed by the Rayas to act as the imperial capital of the entire South India. They built large temples for Sri Virupaksha, Ramachandra, Krishna and Vitala using a style that had been developed by Chola and Pandya emperors of Tamil Nadu. This included the Vimanas and the Gopurams. The Virupaksha temple hall in front of the main shrine was built by Krishna Devaraya to mark his accession. The halls in the temple were used for a special programs of music, dance, drama, etc. Others were used to celebrate the marriages of deities. The famous Lotus Mahal, Queen's Bath and the Elephant Stable are example of the Sultanate architecture. The most impressive remain of Vijayanagara, the Mahanavami Dibba. The Vijayanagara kings held their Navaratri Puja and Dasara court on his platform. Gardens, tombs and ports. Mughal emperors were personally interested in literature, art and architecture. In his autobiography, Babur described his interest in planning and laying out formal gardens placed within rectangular walled enclosures and divided into four quarters by artificial channels. These gardens were called Chahar Bags. Some of the most beautiful Chahar Bags were constructed by Jahangir and Shah Jahan in Kashmir, Agra and Delhi. It was during Shah Jahan's reign that the different elements of Mughal architecture actively, especially in Agra, and Delhi. Shahjahan newly constructed court in the Red Fort at Delhi. Shahjahan's capital was at Agra, a city where the nobility had constructed their homes on the banks of the river Yamuna. The Taj Mahal, grandest architectural accomplishment of his reign. Here the white marble mausoleum was placed on a terrace by the edge of the river and the garden was its to south. Around the same time as the Mughals, the Qutub Shahi rulers of Golconda, construction of Hussain Sagar Lake, the Golconda port, a large number of gardens with water channels. The famous Charminar and Makkah Masjid were built during their rule. Thank you.